हेलो किड्स, दिस इज योर साइंस क्लास लेसन 8, एयर एंड वाटर। एयर, वी विल लर्न अबाउट एयर, प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ एयर एंड यूजेस ऑफ एयर। नाउ एयर, एयर इज ए मिक्सचर ऑफ गैसेस सराउंडिंग द अर्थ। We cannot see air, but we can feel it when it moves. There are three forms of air: wind, breeze, storm. Moving air is called wind. Wind that blows gently is called breeze. A very strongly blowing wind is called a storm. Now, so next is properties of air. The first property of air is air occupies space. But how can we say this? Let's do an activity. Take a balloon and start blowing air into it. What you notice? The balloons becomes bigger and bigger. The second property is air has weight. Let's see the activity first. Take two balloons, the red balloon and blue balloon. And we will fill the air only in blue balloon. Now hang both the balloons of two ends of the stick and hang the string from the center with the thread, and it is the same picture. Now what you notice? The stick which has balloon filled with air weights more and goes down. The next is uses of air. The first is air also dries our clothes faster. Next is air also helps birds to fly in the sky. What does air contain? The smoke makes the air harmful for us. We must try to plant small plants near our houses and schools. Plants make the air pure. Air and water are most essential need for all living things to live. Now we will learn about water. Major part of our earth is covered with water. This is, we live on earth and this is our earth. Can you see this blue color portion? This shows the water. So the major part of our earth is covered with water. Earth is also called as blue planet. Water is natural resource. Plants, animals and human beings need water to live. Animals need water for drinking and bathing. Human beings need water for drinking, cooking, bathing and washing clothes. The last topic is water cycle. The sun heats up the water from the oceans, lakes and rivers, and water changes into water vapor by the process of evaporation. Plants also lose water in the form of water vapor from their leaves into the air by the process of transpiration. As the water vapor rises up into the air, it starts cooling down and forms of tiny water droplets. These water droplets come together to form clouds. This process is called condensation. When the clouds start getting heavy and cannot hold the water droplets anymore, they fall back to the earth in the form of rain, hail, or snow. This process is called precipitation. Some of the water that falls on the earth seeps into the ground. This water is available to us in the form of groundwater. The remaining water falls back into oceans, lakes, rivers, and seas. This process is called collection. The sun starts heating up this water once again. This circulation of water is called water cycle. The end.